find out more about the RovoCam now with Matty Causon, who joins me from AJA. Thank you very much for coming in.
Hello, Nikki. Thank you.
Tell us more then.
Sure, well, there's a lot to cover with the RovoCam, and I hope I cover it all. But so what we're looking at here is a UHD camera. But it's a UHD camera with a difference. So let's just talk about the guts of it a little bit. What we have here is a Sony sensor, the Sony sensor block, and Sony optics. And on the back, AJA have added some technology that we use. HDBaseT is how we're carrying some of the information here. So typically, if you have a UHD camera, you might have a situation where you'd have four cables for the SDI signal, and then you may have an audio cable as well and a power cable. And if you were controlling it, let's say by Sony Visca, you might have up to seven cables that you would need to connect to give you that 4K signal. And that can be a real issue in terms of some installs and control. So what we're able to do here is connect a single RJ45 cable, category cable, and we're able to run that up to 100 meters. And that single cable will carry the power, the video, the audio, and Visca control as well. So you're really in a great situation if you need to have a remote control over a camera over distance. And let's remember, whilst this is using an RJ45 cable, this is not IP, it's not a squeeze signal. So HDBaseT will carry the signal, but it's effectively carrying it as a baseband signal, and you'll get no compression, you'll lose no picture quality at all from that.
So it's very nifty, it's very neat, it's very small, mm-hmm. but it's got massive capabilities as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, don't be fooled by the way it looks. A little bit security camera look like. This is a really high quality camera. So if you're looking to bring in a really high quality image, you know, in a less conventional manner, where you maybe don't have a cameraman sat behind it, you don't want a tripod and the cables, this is a great camera for you. So very high quality, yes.
Who's this aimed at then? Who would this be perfect for in terms of usage?
Well, to be honest, we're finding it going into a lot of different environments, sports, military, and I would say corporate as well, manufacturing, environments where you just need that high quality image without having a traditional camera setup. So in addition, we're able to connect to a computer as well. So if you're wanting to have that remote control, we have RovoControl software that should allow you to go in and set up white balance, match cameras,
Fantastic.
Control multiple cameras, upload firmware revisions, etc., etc. So pretty much everything you would expect to do off the side of a traditional UHD camera, we can do remotely as well, and that can be very, very useful.
Brilliant, because it's very neat. It does look quite boxy, doesn't it? But like you say, there's no buttons, there's no zoom, there's no. So you do all of that remotely via the software?
Yeah, and you've got a couple of choices. So you're able to do that via software, but if you want physical control, this is also using the Sony Visca protocol as well. So Visca controllers will be able to go in and control parts of the Sony mechanisms that are working here and so on. So for zoom and certain types of control, or if you want to actually have a physical pan, tilt, zoom device underneath it, we can control that remotely via Visca as well. But I should say something else that we have within the software is an ability to use the electronic PTZ as well. So if the camera's locked off in one position, but you want to use that 4K geometry to be able to zoom into a particular area, we're able to do that electronically. So there's no moving parts at that point, but we use the UHD image to make a crop. And we can even record the movements of that crop. So if you're in a situation, let's say you're in a, you're shooting a parliament and there's a particular figure you want to zoom into, zoom back out from, that can be recorded as a movement.
Okay.
And we can even lock off things like contrast control in that environment as well. So there's a lot of software control that's available for that.
Very clever. And what's this other component you've got?
Yeah, so what we've got here is when we take our RJ45 cable out the back of the unit, we do plug into a receiver. So we're just looking at the HDMI version here. So simply we would come in and that's our HDBaseT connection. So we've got a single uninterrupted RJ45 connection going to here, which will run 100 meters. And then we break out into a more conventional video world. So we'd have HDMI output here. We can see if we're locked. We've got an RS-232 connector, so that's what we would connect to the Visca unit via. We've got a USB connector here for configuration update of firmware through this, and audio out as well.
lovely, nice, neat setup.
Yeah.
Can I have a little hold of that then?
You
I'm intrigued as to how much it weighs. And it weighs nothing at all, really, does it? You know, if you look at it compared to a large, kind of cumbersome camera, that's really quite light.
And it's made to a Sony specific size, so you probably see those white enclosures where you see security cameras outside of buildings and so on. This is a standard size that this will fit into. So if you're in a situation where you wanted to keep it waterproofed, it'll fit into that Sony enclosure. But also they build versions of that enclosure that either heat or cool an environment. So if you've got it in a very extreme weather environment, we can take use of that as well. So
make sure your equipment's safe and well looked after.
Yes, absolutely.
Fantastic. Well, thank you very much for coming in and talking us through the RovoCam.
Sure,
happy. Product.
Yeah, just a quick overview, but do look on the website aja.com. There'll be some more information, or the SCAM website, of course.
Thank you.
Thank you.